My name is Luis Mendoza. I'm Senior Director of Business Development at Zscaler. At Zscaler, we help our customers in their digital transformation journey to the cloud and mobility. Our services run on a global network that is deployed in over 150 data centers around the world that is capable of managing about 75 billion transactions on a daily basis. For 8 consecutive years in a row, we've been named as leader in Gartner's Magic Quadrant. Zscaler Internet Access enables our customers to allow their entire employee base to securely access the internet and SaaS applications. It is essentially something where we've taken all of the traditional security elements in the stack that used to be deployed on premises and perhaps 4 to 6 different hubs around the world for large enterprise customers. And we've taken all of that in a single platform that now runs all the different functions you can expect to see in parallel, making it very efficient and highly scalable. Our integration with Microsoft Azure Sentinel allows customers to ingest 100% of the transactions that are created by all of their employees worldwide, to take information from other clouds, including Azure, Office 365, and third-party clouds, as well as all of the data that now is provided through Zscaler. At a functional level, for every transaction, we create a log file. The log file gets to be stored on the NanoLog database. At the same time, we've created a function that is called NSS, the NanoLog Streaming Service. This function gets to sit on top of Azure virtual machines, and it's responsible for creating a secure tunnel to be able to collect all of the customers' log files. The last piece there is a connector that gets deployed through Azure Sentinel in the management console. This collector is readily available, and it takes the information coming from NSS function and allows it to ingest right into Azure Sentinel. It's very simple. On the Zscaler side, it is all about the NSS function itself, that is licensed per user per year. And then on the Azure side, it's part of the standard subscription of the Azure tenant that customers open up, and they just go ahead and start selecting and deploying, provisioning these services from Azure Sentinel.